Custom JavaScript variable in Google Tag Manager comes in handy when you can't find a variable that satisfies your tracking needs. In this video, I will show you step by step how to create a custom JavaScript variable and give you an example that you can use right away. At the end, I will also show you how you can learn more about JavaScript for Google Tag Manager. So if you're ready, let's dive in. In Google Tag Manager, go to Variables and scroll down to User-Defined Variables and click on New. Click in the middle to configure the variable. We are going to use custom JavaScript variable. So go ahead and click on it. And this is where you can write a JavaScript function. The value that's returned from that JavaScript function is going to be the value that's assigned to the variable. For this example, I'm going to write a very simple JavaScript function so you can see how this works. In order to do that, you write anonymous function, which means the function does not need a name. If you're not familiar with anonymous functions, then check the link in the description of this video. Just to recap, anonymous functions are similar to other functions, except that they don't need a name. And that's what we use in custom JavaScript variables. So let's go ahead and write that function syntax. So function, opening and closing parentheses, and then you have curly brackets, and then end curly brackets. Within these two curly brackets is where your logic will go and your return statement will be. Let's go ahead and write simple statement here to pull the value of the protocol from the Windows object. So here we will write the full statement to get the value. First, I'm going to define a variable var and call it protocol val. Then I'm going to assign the value to this variable. So protocol val is equal to document.location.protocol. Go ahead and put the semicolon. If you're not familiar with this syntax, then go back to the Windows object as well as JavaScript variable lectures to become familiar with the syntax. Now the protocol value is assigned. I can go ahead and return that. So return protocol val, call val. To recap the logic here, we created an anonymous function with opening and closing parentheses and two curly brackets. Within these two curly brackets is our logic. In this function right here, I'm reading document.location.protocol value and assigning it to protocol val. And then I'm returning that variable. Now go ahead and save this function and give it a name. I'm going to call it CJS protocol val. Go ahead and save it. Go up and put your container in preview mode. Pick the right site, connect. And now Tag Assistant is connected. Let's go to Tag Assistant, click on Continue, and click on Windows Loaded, click on Variables, and here you can see CJS protocol val, that's coming as HTTPS. That's the value that's returned from document.location.protocol. This was a simple function that we created. Now I can do other sorts of processing here and return a different value. You can write as complex a logic as you want. The whole concept here is to write your logic and return a value. That value then gets assigned to a variable, which you can then use in your tags, triggers, and variables. If you are interested in seeing more use cases and examples of custom JavaScript variable, then check out the link in the description of this video. There is a complete course that I have created to teach you JavaScript step by step that you can use for Google Tag Manager as well as any other environment. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to give it a thumbs up, leave a comment for me, and let me know your thoughts on this video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon so that you never miss any new videos from me. I will see you in the next video.